G'day folks, it's the Meeple Monkey here again with another unboxing video for you. So taking a little bit of a break from all the Marvel United content, and this is a big Kickstarter that's just arrived on my doorstep the other day. So yeah, we're going to have a look at Vindication. So this is actually not the base game. We've got the base game here. There we go, Vindication. Big game there. Sort of like a big storytelling adventure game theme, but with a Euro mechanism, so big sort of resource building, sort of cube pushing type game. A lot of fun, beautiful components, and yeah, just a really slick production and a really fun gameplay as well. But something very different than what you might expect with the premise of the game. So yeah, really good. But it's got quite a lot of content, and in fact, I've already got a pre-existing sort of expansion from a previous Kickstarter campaign. But this is, I think, their third campaign with some new expansions. So we've got the Villages and Hamlets, we've got the Chronicles, a bunch of sort of promo decks and upgrades and things like that. You could get a playmat as well, which I didn't get. But then they also, I think it's about halfway through the campaign, they came up with this idea of having a big all-in box type thing. So I've got quite a few of these now. If you've probably seen some of my other unboxings recently, there's quite a lot of these big giant boxes coming out for a lot of games. But since I've got a lot more content, I thought, yeah, let's get another big box. And so what we're going to do today, I'll have a look through the new stuff here, and then I'll try and show you what it looks like sort of transferring all the stuff from the original game into the big box. So that's the plan. So let's have a look at it. So we've got Chronicles expansion here, so you can see adds a whole bunch of sort of modular stuff, I think, here, bits and pieces, and I think this is like an event deck type track and all that sort of stuff. So we'll have a look at that when we get into it. We've got these Villages and Hamlets, which kind of expand the world exploration part of the game. There's a big map in the middle of the board for the original game, but this gives you some extra locations to go and visit, add some different sort of dice rolling mechanisms and that sort of thing as well. So that looks cool as well. We've got this, what's this say? This is the free bonus loot. So this might kind of be like a stretch goal, sort of just a pack for all the sort of stretch goalie type stuff that was in the campaign, maybe. Odyssey, yeah. World Box Odyssey, yeah, no idea what that means, but again, a really well-researched unboxing video here. And but I can tell you that Orange Nebula, the company that makes this game, are a top company. I probably put them up there alongside Chip Theory Games in terms of just awesome customer support and engagement with their community, and just a really cool bunch of people, and they've all sort of got this sort of, I think, like design background as well, so all of their stuff looks really really slick. Another big favorite game of mine of theirs is Unsettled as well, which is that really cool exploration sort of space game as well. So but you can see here, this is the what is this? This is the big box here. So, and this does come with some content as well. So, adds some new trays and a new way to store everything. But it does come with some extra cards, I think, or something like that as well. Or these, sorry, not cards, but these action trackers and that sort of thing as well. So, let's see if we can bring that up here. So, yeah, but we'll get down and have a look at this properly. So, let's start with the big box, I guess. Okay, so we have the big empty box here, or relatively empty box. So this is coming off nice and easy though. Nice and, oh, what a smooth glide this is. But this is, I think, if you were buying Vindication for the first time, if you weren't just getting the expansions with this campaign, I think you could get this box already sort of pre-filled, pre-packed for you. So we've got this big giant, wow, that's huge. I hope you can see that, look at that. That's a thick book. So this is like the all of the previous sort of rules materials and all the books sort of from previous editions and previous expansions, plus these new expansions, all in one big thick easy to grab reference. So that's very cool. Yeah, you can see there all the different guides and stuff that this sort of packs together. Wow, that's very cool. I think there might even be like a new solo mode in this. I could be wrong. Again, zero research done, but that would be cool because they've actually already got two solo modes, which are both pretty fun. So here we have the new trays that hold everything. The previous game had these smaller trays, which were great, really nicely designed, but you've got more stuff, I think, now with all the expansion. So this just lets you sort of update that. So yeah, you've got the nice see-through clear lid there. These are the new action trackers. So you put these little circular discs in here and can slide them across to show whether you've done the actions there. So if I can hold that up for you. That's pretty cool, and you've got a little reminder of your bonus actions. That's nice. They've combined the reminder sort of cheat sheet with the action tracker. Very cool. And then you've got some artwork on the back for your character. Okay, so the table can also enjoy the game. So that's very cool. And yeah, so we've got our components there. So hopefully later on in the video, I'll show you what all this stuff looks like packed up. But you've got your different player colors here. So we've got the orange. Let's have a look. The blue, nice little light blue there. Oh, the lighting on my camera is looking a bit funny there, but this looks a lot nicer. We've got the sunlight actually coming in, so it's probably affecting the light here with this video with my super technical digital skills. But yeah, we've got green. So this, I feel like this green's a little bit more of a lime green in real life. Very cool. So there's three of them there. I think the others are down in here somewhere as well. So there's actually more. I think there's at least one more player color. Maybe, I can't remember if it's four or five players. All right, so we've got this big tray here. Again, nice fits. It's not too tight, not too loose. Feels really nice. That's for a lot of different components there, I guess. I think these might be for those big event deck type things and bits and pieces. So again, another big one of these trays here. Okay, again, let's see. Oh yeah, that comes off nice and smooth. This, yeah, top quality, guys. They're always on point with their production quality. This is nice. I think this is all in-house. I think they've designed these all themselves. This is not game trays, I don't think. Game trays are beautiful, don't get me wrong. And I could be wrong, but I think game trays might have done. Oh no, my apologies. Well, apologies, game trays. I'm telling fibs, because check this out. I don't know if you can make that out. Game trays. So that's made a liar of me. Oh, good thing I didn't get any further than that. Alright, so, well, I take it back then. This wasn't designed in-house. However, they probably had a big hand in sort of like specifying to game trays what they wanted. And game trays, as always, did a nice job, knocked it out of the park. And here are those two other player colors. So yeah, there are five player colors, so it looks like you can play up to five players. Now we've got two boxes here. Ooh, one's got stuff in it, one doesn't. So, well, maybe it does, but it doesn't feel like it's as heavy. So we've got these two boxes here. I think these are for the square cards, which is sort of like the majority of the cards in the game. So we've got this nice box here, got your symbols along the side. These, I think, represent your different resource types linked to different factions there. We've got these are the player color discs that go in those action trackers. So nice wooden discs there. Very sweet. Okay. And then, yeah, so you've got these card holders that you can just sort of have them sliding in there. And I think they have some dividers as well for you. So very nice. Let's have a look at some of that artwork, because someone has worked very hard on this. This is probably designed before the advent of all that AI art. So this is actually someone's spent some time to craft this. Oh, look at that. Fantastic. Nice. All right. Chuck that back in there. All right. Now this one feels a lot heavier, so there must be some cards or something in here. Maybe dividers as well, so some nice art there. What's that? Atlas holding up a pumpkin? Alright, so I think that's how the story went. Oh, look at this, squirrel. Alright, with a bread roll. Nice. Okay. Something's rolling around in there. Oh, this kid set fire to everyone else's house there. That's not good. Alright, so Again, we've got these symbols. Okay. Very nice. And then, oh yeah, oh wow, these are, oh, look at this. Thick boys. All right, so very thick. Look at that. I think it's got black core. Cardboard. Exquisite cardboard there. Very nice. Yeah, very solid, chunky. Your dividers. And so they've got just kind of like a blank divider here with a symbol. And then on this side, you've got this specific like solo game or, oops, sorry, bumping the camera there. Solo game with the two different sort of characters there, or the two different baddies. So yeah, you can kind of choose how you want to put these in and separate your cards out. So you've got title, you know, legendary powers, your choice of what picture you want, and then you've even got just the color coding. So if you know the game well enough, you might know, okay, that's legendary powers. And if you want to like with a minimalist look without the text there, you've got that option too. So wow, very cool. They've let's have a look there. Yeah, they slide in. Oops, sorry, not doing that very well for the camera, am I? They slide in nicely there. So yeah, very cool. Very, very cool. So hopefully I'll be able to show you this all set up with the cards too. And hopefully I'll be able to show you that it holds sleeved cards as well. Fingers crossed. Now I'm hoping, not sure if I didn't actually get any sleeves with this set. So I'm hoping I've got sleeves that match the cards. Otherwise I might have to pick up some more. Okay. And then, down the bottom here, this is your tray that sort of holds all the minis that come in the original game as well. So let's pull this out to see if there's any secrets underneath. No secrets. There you go. So you don't have to worry about looking for secrets. Okay. There's just so many board game companies hide things under the inserts now. You've always got to check, right? It's like watching a Marvel movie. You've got to stick around to the end. Okay, so yeah, very cool. Well, that's the big box. We'll chuck things back in here. We'll have a look at the expansions, and then we'll and some of the extra content, and then we'll look at putting it all back together again. Whoopsie daisy. All right, see you on the other side. All right, now we have the Chronicles box. Okay, these cool two statues here flanking this mysterious figure. Yeah, here we go. So this looks like it's quite a modular set. Let's get into it. All right. Sticky plastic there. All right, so we'll pop this open. Make sure I'm centering that so you can see it. Yep, nice feel to the box as well. So these, I guess I don't need because everything's going in the big box, but they are nice boxes. So if you need to store other things and you don't want to waste the materials, yeah, nice sturdy boxes so you can reuse those, I guess, if you need to. I believe all of this stuff in this booklet goes into the big box because you didn't have to buy the big box. You could just store all this stuff separately in its own little boxes like this. So you do get the rules specifically for this expansion here. Nice glossy. Their rule books are always like really nicely produced. Sometimes, I will say, sometimes the layout is sometimes seems more design like, you know, really nice looking, but not necessarily the easiest way to sort of follow and explain a game. But to be honest, I've always been able to play their games pretty easily and not been too confused. So I guess they can't be that astray. So that's pretty good. Excellent. And also, I've never tried to design a rule book myself, so I'm sure it's pretty tough. Okay, so yeah, oh, look at this, so nice. Just feels chunky and solid. This is the same in the previous, like the actual original game, just really nice, feels lovely in the hand. And the game board itself is just, oh, just schmick, it just feels so good. Okay, it's even got a little bit of a, you sort of press your finger into it a little bit, it's got a little bit of give to it, it's like, feels like a nice velvet couch or something. So there you go. Velvet couch, leather couch, I think is what I meant to say. But yeah, neither of which is a great metaphor for a board game. Okay, so yeah, that's coins again, same thickness. Yeah, really nice. Not sure if they're coins or points or whatever they are, but yeah, they feel nice. This, I believe, is like a board to hold the event cards or something like that as well. Again, zero research into what is actually in here, so take everything I say with a grain of salt. or maybe wait for someone to put up a video who knows what they're talking about. Dark Agent tokens, different bits and pieces here. So, yep, all very nice. Got some different things on the back there of those Dark Agent tokens. Okay. Here we go. So maybe these are like different events in the different locations attached to the different sort of hexes or the different sides of the big hex board. So yeah, that's cool. So I'm assuming we'll have some of these in all the different colors. Now, not colors of the player colors, but colors, or I could be wrong, maybe they are the player colors. Or I think they might just be like the resource type colors. So yeah, that's nice. Okay. Mm-hmm. I don't know, maybe those are player colours. Alright, Firewind, some sort of festival. Okay, very cool. There you go, you've got your different areas there. And that grey doesn't really match up with these, does it? So maybe those are player colours. Hmm. Okay. For those of you trying to read, I guess you can maybe take a screenshot or something. Whoops, I probably shouldn't scroll it up so far, should I? There we go. Some nice background there. The writing's always top-notch from these guys as well. They've got away with words. All right. Ooh. Pads. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Yeah. So, the Roll and Write expansion. Not sure what this is, but very cool. Another one. Mm-hmm. And another one. And another one. Guessing enough for each player, I guess. Okay. Wow, that's generous. They give you tons of these. Awesome. Nicely designed tray in here too. Let's hold it up so you can see. Nice and sturdy. Yep, very nice. So here we have these big vents, I think. Let's have a look at these. Oh, look, it's one of these nice. Nice, where are they? Oh, well, it does have a little thing you can pull around, but it just comes straight off anyway. Oopsie, don't know if I was showing that properly. There we go. But yeah, that's very easy to open. Pull that open. Here we go. So, and these have the same little indent, just like their square cards as well. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, that's funny. All right. These are kind of like a tarot size, so hopefully they'll fit in tarot sleeves. Let's have a look at some of these. So, so we've got something at the top here. Some rules instructions. So I think this is like flavor text. And you've got, okay, this is what you actually do with this thingy, and then this is maybe like the reward or something you get as well. Or maybe something, you know, the thing you can do. Interesting. Alright. So let's have a look at some of these. Just move them up so you guys can see. Let's just do a few of them. Oh, that's kind of timely at the moment, isn't it? There's lots of that going on. Okay. Yep. Mm-hmm. And then I might just sort of shuffle through them for you. Go into too much detail. You can sort of have some fun yourself. There we go. Feel free to skip past this if you don't want to be too spoiled. Oh, the Great Mall, that's a fun place to go fight those monsters. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at this. It's geometry as well. Do a math lesson. There we go. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, I like that. That's a cool picture. Mm-hmm. So I wonder if these are tied to different... Yeah, these must tie to the different hexes. This is the art on the different hexes. I'm recognizing some of this stuff. All right. So this obviously tells you, like, okay, this is where this event is taking place on the board. Mm-hmm. All right. Handy dandy. So, oh, and what do we got here? We got something else that I don't know what it is, but the Gleaming Guide, Fount of Loyalty. The Lone Claw, Monster Hunter Extraordinaire. So yeah, these look like they're tied to the different sort of six spheres of resource cube. So maybe like if you get some sort of area control of those things or something like that, or, you know, majority or something, maybe you get rewarded with these or something, or there's some sort of goal. Nice, nice, nice. We have some little sleeves here. Whoopsie daisy. The shroud for solo play. Okay, so you must be able to slide cards into these so that you can't. Oh, yeah, I think that's for this stuff. I think you can. I don't know if you do it this way. Let's have a look. You know, so you can read. You can read the choice or whatever you've got to make or whatever it might be, and then reveal it sort of thing. I think that's something to do with that. So, yeah, that's cool. Solo play, yep, nice. Because I think normally the other person, like if you're playing multiplayer, like someone else will draw a card and read it to you, and you can make a choice. But this way you can play solo and still sort of not spoil yourself. So, yeah, awesome. Got some stand. Oh gosh, Alexa's listening in. We got our tokens. Not tokens. Standee holders. Yep. Nice, nice plastic ones. And little black cubes. So I think you get black cubes in the other one. So you must need more for some of their modes or something. Just little wooden black cubes. Nothing too special. Nice. Okay. And here we go. See if we can pull that back so you can see it clearly. Put a little tab there. Slide that open. These are their normal card sizes. These little square things with the indents in them. So, all right. So what are these? What do they say? Chronicle Curio Shop. Okay, so like equipment or something. Nostalgia's Grip. What's written on the heart? Well, I'll let you guys read some of those. Again, are these more choices? Maybe these are what the shroud thing are for. So you put these in. Yeah, see, working it out as we go along. All right, maybe you do something like this. You read the thing, you make a choice, and then you go to whichever side you've chosen. Wow, okay, cool. See, I'll tell you, you don't need to do any research, you just read it as you go along. All right, sorry guys. Top quality videos from the Meeple Monkey. All right, so, and good singing too. Just more of these. I think they're all tied to, I'm guessing these are tied to the different, these are tied to the different locations. Cool, because the Arcane Tower is like the purple one and the Tomb of the Ancients is the green one. Yep, so that's cool. Okay, I don't know what this is though. Curio Shop, that must be a new location. Okay, so let's have a gander at, let's check this one out. Alright, crikey, let's have a look here. So, Chronicle Inn. Wow, there's tons of the inns, because I think there's actually quite a few inns, so there's probably multiple of those on the board, so you're likely to sort of come across them. Same sort of thing. So I'll just show you a couple here, so you can get an idea of some of the flavour. Ooh, Puppy Dog Fight. That's an interesting one. Okay. Tall Tales. Am I holding that close enough? You can look at it. You can read it. Mm-hmm. My goodness. Certainly a lot of content here. A lot of content. You would have to play, I would assume you'd have to play quite a bit to get through all of this. Righty then. Holy moly. Where's that little thingy? Is it over this side? Alright. Oh goodness. Come on. Sounds like a job for cutting the video. Alright, so there we go. Ooh, Simian Schemes. I like that. I do like my monkeys. Okay. Very cool. Alright, there's the Meeple Monkey endorsed card. That's cool. I like it. Alright. True Motivations. Light of Reason. First Impressions. Very important. Too Hot to Handle. Flurlings. Don't know what a flurling is, but well, there you go. They're like fleas, but worse. Okay. Cool. Alrighty then. Well, we're all done looking at that. So yeah, lots of events and bits and pieces there. That's quite cool. I like the Chronicles. So that's, I guess, that's, I guess that's what these are, right? These are the Chronicles cards. These give you these different sort of events and stuff. And that's the name of the expansion. So there you go. That's what that's all about. See, we're piecing it together. We're piecing it together. All right. Bingo. We've got the world building expansion, or world expanding. You know, we're going outside the bounds of the map. So, assuming this is going to have a lot of tiles and dice, it looks like. So, nice little picturesque scene there. You don't often see that on many of the pictures. The pictures are all usually a little bit sort of over the top and bombastic in this game. But yeah, that's just nice, idyllic little village. I'm sure there's no roving band of monsters that are about to descend on it. Okay, so again, really cool. Nice and glossy. This would be in that big book as well. So we've got this little island over here. So you've got space for three extra hexes. You've got this location, which is like a little port that I assume you sort of slide in on the board, because the board sort of has these similar hexes with these little triangle sections around them. So I'm assuming you slide this in somewhere on the edge of the board, and then if you travel to this location, you can then sail out to this separate board. So that's my guess. Mm-hmm. Because that's how we do it around here. We've got awesome player cheat sheet things for the expansion module. Very cool. Let me have a look at that. Mm-hmm. Check it out. All right, we've got some stuff there for you. Nice. Okay. Holy moly. All right, there's a lot of these in here. So again, beautiful, lovely. Okay, some sort of secret hideaway here, village. So these are all different villages and hamlets with names, I guess. Dobney's Wish. Okay. Dreamwood. Some little acorns there. Cool. Let's go through these so you can see them. Hopefully there's not too much glare there. Sweet. Okay, oh, look at this rainbow one. My daughter would like that. Mm-hmm. Oh, I like that. It looks cool. What's that one called? The Temple. Temple of Legends. Oh, sounds cool too. Oh, look at this theater. It's pretty sweet. Sounds like you might find a monkey there. All right. Nice. Oh, yeah, I think this is like you build... This is like three parts of one big giant tower. That's kind of cool. And then you got some pretty fierce looking dude there hiding in the shadows. Mm-hmm. It's a cool picture. I think we looked at all those, didn't we? Yep, let's keep going. What have we got here? Some hidden ruins. So I'm wondering if these are different on the back. Oh yeah, look at that. Different rewards or different things you can discover there. Nice. And I think we've got some more of these. So these are more locations. So that other one was like an island you can sail to, whereas these are specific places you can go and sort of expand out on. So I guess maybe each of those towns has its own sort of board you can go visit. Yeah, like the Dobney's Wish and the... Is that Tarsi's Riddle? Tarki's Riddle? I don't know if that C is soft or hard. And Verfuro's Secret. Verfuro's Secret. Secret sort of place in the valley. Very cool. Alright. Oh wow, we've got more of these little packets. Look at these little guys hiding in there. Okay, we've got a big baggie. Nice. Whoa. Quality. Yep, get your hand in there. My hand's not too big, so I don't know. People with giant mitts might have a bit of trouble there, but nice colour. Alright, we've got... Oh, look at these sweet suckers. Alright. Oh, chunky. Holy moly. Are these bigger than the ones that come in the original game? These are huge. Oh, they feel so good. Look at that. Look at that shine. Look at that curve. So smooth. Very nice. Some chunky dice. Alright, Cool. And we have just some little standee things there. I was going to tear into some promo thingies now, but let's tear into these ones. A little thing we can tear. Oh, yeah, here. All right. So let's tear into it. Oh, jeez. Boy, oh boy. I'm in more trouble with that than I should have. Okay. Don't want to damage the cards. There we go. Nice. All right. So what are these? We got loot, coercer, is it characters? Maybe it's a bit of a mix of everything. But these ones look like they've got these black borders, or I don't know, headers, I guess. And I think these signify that these are, yeah, they're all, so these are probably all fairly nasty, sort of like player interactions, sort of like take that type cards. Let's have a look. Lose one honor, an adjacent map player rolls the black die augment. Yeah, so it's sort of, yeah, it must pay you two influence. It's all sort of like stuff that sort of like harms the enemy, it looks like, or sort of interacts with the enemy. So if you like that sort of argy-bargy stuff, you can chuck them in. Not usually my cup of tea, but good to have it there just in case, I guess. And this is, whoa, what does that say? 15 card loot pack. So I'm guessing this is all just equipment. Is it actual loot cards, or do they just mean loot as in it's loot for us? Well, good news is we can find out right now. We have, what's this thing here? A deer or something? It kind of looks like an otter with horns. All right, shield. Cool. Strength infused loot. Nice. Okay, yeah, it's all different equipment. Cool. Where do you go to get these? Loot, it's just loot, okay. Loot, I can't remember that as a mechanic. I wonder if this is like they've added this, you can go to a certain location to get this, or if this is like a new thing for like fighting monsters, you get loot. Yeah, kill a monster, get a loot. Don't know. Mm-hmm. Hopefully you guys can get a good sense of these. Holy moly. Well, yeah, I think this game has arrived in Oz. I don't know if it's arrived elsewhere around the world, so if you haven't got this yet, trust me, it's pretty good quality. It's looking like another great production. Let's have a look at this big boy here. And when I say big boy, I mean this thing. The Odyssey box. We're just housing all the extra stretch goals. All right. Pull that open. Oh man, more of these little decks. Oh, what's this? What? Okay, we've got some sort of iron-on transfer thing. Let the dead past bury its dead. That's cool. All right, little iron-on transfer there. We've got a sticker. Cool. We've got, now that's one of the symbols of the different sort of resource cube sort of zones or whatever. So I wonder if they chuck it like a random one in each pack. And so like they're kind of like a collectible now. You can trade with your friends. Okay. Odyssey. Well, story patch. There you go. Gives a little bit of info there about what that's about. Yeah, cool. All right. So all the little bits and pieces in here do have a explanation. We've got this track here, the Odyssey track, tame and exotic pack. These are like feats or something, are they? Try and do these things here. Hunt for bounty. Okay. Again, feels super good. Dual layer, very cool. I wonder if that fits in the big box. Looks like it would. That big box is pretty huge. Alright, we're looking at now a 15 card promo pack from 2020. I did notice the other one I think said 2021. I can't remember if I got the 2020 pack. I can't remember when I ordered the previous expansion. I got Vindication, got into it late, so I didn't get it in its first run. I got it when they were making their first expansion. I can't remember what year that was. So do I recognize these? I do not. So maybe that was back like 2018 or 19 or something. So I don't think I've got these. Very cool. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right. What else have we got? No, that's another thing. Hold on. Did we get everything out of that box? All right. I think we got everything. My goodness, getting myself all mixed up here. There's just so many things in there. All right. I think that's fine. So we've got these two as well. Or do we? Did I open that one already? Oh, no, we've got this over here. What's happening? My goodness. All right. Yeah, these are the other two that just came loose in the big mailbox. So we've got the Wintertide cards and this community pack. So let's have a look at these Wintertide cards first, and then we'll finish off with the community. Nice way to finish. Because they often do a thing where they work with the community during the Kickstarter campaigns. These guys look pretty sinister. Cool. Yeah, and they put together like some sort of pack like this, or a planet box in the Unsettled games. So yeah, good company for working with their fans. Okay, and I think this is the last of the content. And trust me, there's tons of content in the original, plus its expansions as well. So lots. There's a reason this game has one of these big giant boxes now. It's there's a lot to fit in if you've got everything. So here we go. This guy's like some sort of butterfly guy. This guy's a juggler. It's like, yeah, cool story, bro. Everyone can juggle. All right, so... No, I can't. All right, so... here we go. Yep. I think this is like what this person imagines their back tattoo looks like, but it's actually just this sort of like cruddy little thing on their back, but they think they're really cool with these big wings. All right, so that's been... Oh, wait a second, what's going on? Is that... That's not on these ones. Holy moly, just making fun of this guy now. I'm impressed. What's going on here? Ooh, shiny, look at that. That's pretty fancy. Yeah. Dragon. I feel like I've got this card already, but this I don't have a shiny version of it. All right. Cool. Well, there you go. That's awesome. Well, what we'll do, I'll cut away, and then we'll see what it all looks like back in the big box. So let's check that out. Alrighty then, we're back again. And so I've unboxed everything, put... everything from the original game inside, well, except for this little transfer thing or whatever it is, put everything inside the big box. Now you can see I just can't bring myself to sort of get rid of these little booklets and stuff at the moment. I just really have to get, I guess I'll just have to chuck them out. But yeah, I've got a few extra things in here that I probably don't need, but they're in here as well, so they do fit. So yeah, I've got all the little bits and pieces, but really what you would probably only need is, and I guess you wouldn't need all these bags, but we've got 1, 2, and 3 different cloth bags there. You've got your big rule book that sits on the top. Again, you won't need these necessarily. Get rid of these. I've just put the notepads on the top as well. There is actually, before we dive into this any further, just so you know you're in good hands and you don't have to follow my shoddy advice here, there is actually a itemized list of all the things, plus how to put them in, what order they go, all that stuff. So I've sort of followed this almost to a T. I did run into a little bit of a hiccup once or twice, but if you guys read this carefully, I was kind of rushing through it, you might find that you get through it a bit easier. So we've got all these old little booklets and stuff here. I wasn't sure whether this little Odyssey booklet is included in the big booklet. I should actually have a look. Oh, well, there you go. It does say, I don't know if you can see that there. Oops. It does say Odyssey here, so I'm assuming I can get rid of this, but not prepared to do that just yet. I've also slid these little shroud things on the top here, player aids, all that sort of stuff, and these notepads. Now this I couldn't find in the instructions where to put this. It didn't seem to have a spot, so I've just got this on the top as well. It does specifically call out though to put this floating on the top as well, this big Odyssey board as well, so that is where it's supposed to be. Now you've got three, oh, and this is, now it does actually point out putting the solo board in one of the, in one of these trays here, but it didn't seem to fit as well as this other board, so I just kind of have got this floating on top as well. And that's one of the things I ran into, but I'm sure if you slow down and take your time with this and have a look at it properly, there's probably a spot for that. So three of the player board, or the player trays, fit on the top, and they actually have these little snug spots they lock into here, so if you put them on the side here they don't rock around too much, and then you've got space for that Odyssey board. These, I forget what these are called, the influence boards, these just sort of sit, but they have like a little indent that they sit in, so they're nice and easy. I'll only go through one of these because they're all identical, but then you have this expansion board here, I think it's like a monuments board or something like that, that sits in there over the top, that holds everything inside in place. They've all got their own spots though, so they sit in there pretty nicely. You've got your transport or your movement tiles here, you've got your action tracker sitting on there. Underneath here you've got your actual sort of character board here, your three circular action tracker little tokens there. You've got your little movement piece, so I actually used to swap out with minis for these, but they're quite nice though, very very shiny, look very nice. Kind of an abstract piece for representing your character on the board. Then underneath here we have all your influence tokens. You've got your, I think it's your conviction token or something like that, I'm not sure what that, forget what that's called. You've got also this, I think it's like your score tracker, that all sits in there nicely, so that's where that all goes. And then underneath here we do have some spots for 1, 2, 3 of these, whatever those are. Okay, so we'll pop this back on top, nice and easy, keeps it all contained, and that sits on the top there. Slot that over the top, doesn't really matter, either way it fits both ways. Yeah, very easy, and that sits on the top there, so we've got the three of those sitting on the top. Okay, now next we have two of these card trays. Now this one is empty, okay, because I was able to fit everything else in the first one, and that is because I did not go and have a proper look to see if I have the right sleeves for these guys. So I did originally have all the original stuff sleeved, but you can see that they fit in there very nicely. The sleeve stuff, there's plenty of room obviously this way, they fit in nicely, so that's beautiful. You can see, nice and easy, you can see exactly what you're looking for, especially if you put the words at the top there rather than using the other side. If I flip them around this way you can see that it's got the just the color coding, if you prefer to do it that way. But you can see here at the back here I've got a bunch of unsleeved cards, and I've slotted in all the extra sort of new unsleeved cards in their spots here, so this fills up fine for now. But obviously the more, if you've got the sleeved cards, they're going to fill up more room. So that's where this will come in handy, having this extra tray there. And yeah, that's all fine. So I sort of had it sort of set up in this sort of order, if you can see that in the original box. So I imagine what I'll probably do is maybe take a lot of this Chronicle stuff and some of the, you know, the promos and that sort of thing, and have that in a separate slot there, that way I can play games without the Chronicles if I want to, I guess, and go from there. But you guys can make your own choices about how you're going to sort of separate these across the two different trays if you're going to do that. So, but yeah, that fits perfectly. So sleevers, definitely plenty of room with the two trays that you're going to get that in. I think they've given us plenty of room for expansions and that sort of thing as well, so yeah, definitely you will get everything in there and it all sits nicely, so that's fantastic. So we'll pop those aside. Now those two things, as you saw, they sit there and they sort of hold these in place. And these are your three big trays for most of the components of the game. So this one here, I think, is your villages and hamlets board or tray. You've got your floating island that sort of sits in this little spot here. You've got your it's just the village. Yeah, the village sits over the top here. Now again, I don't know if these are called out in the instructions, but I've just slid these sort of player aids just on the top here. You do put this is a previous expansion, leaders and something like that, leaders and monuments or something. You put those sitting in this well here, and then you've got a couple of the what are they, hamlets. The two hamlets sit there. And you have all the other stuff from this expansion. So you've got the little port city that sits in there. You've got your dice sitting along here. These are some acorn tokens. These are these sort of flamey tokens. I think it's from the solo mode from the one of the old expansions. You've got your two upgraded dice. I'll probably swap these in and put them in the other main tray as well, because I like using the upgraded ones here. But these two dice sit in here. I forget what this token's called. It's again from one of the other expansions. It sits in here. You've got a couple of mercenaries in this spot, in these two spots here. Mercenary standees. You've got these little, I forget what these are called, rune map tokens or something like that. And they sit in there. So, yep, all nice. They've all got the little spots. Their previous, see if I can find it. Is it sitting here? I think I put it back in the box. But their previous insert had like a little individualized little inset for just about every single component. So like if you had this thing here, it would be sitting in its own little specially shaped thing like that. So with these, you know, I'll show you some later, but they've really put a bit more of these just sort of loose wells in here for a lot of these components now, which just are a bit easier to just grab things out of and are less sort of wasteful, I think. So that's pretty good. Seems like it's pretty functional. So yeah, happy with that. So let's see if I can remember how to put this back in without having to read the instructions. Slot that in there. It all sort of makes sense. These would go over the top here. This board's nice and easy to remember because you just have this little inset bit. You just remember that that's facing this way. And then that sits in there like so. You have your village board, and then that sits over the top, and we can just pop this over the top. And these lids are the same for all three of these, and they help you situate each other on top of each other there. So we've got our next one. This is the Chronicles board, I think, or Chronicles, I keep saying board, don't I? Chronicles tray. Now this is the one where I think it says to put the solo board on top of here, but I couldn't see how that really fit very nicely. So this one fits perfectly, this Firewind board. Maybe this is a solo board and that's what they're referring to, I don't know, but the old solo board doesn't seem to fit in here. I don't know, maybe that's obsolete or something now. Could be totally wrong though. So that sits in there like that. You can see plenty of room for sleeved cards here, I believe. I haven't tested that out, so but in terms of depth, that's going to be great. I'm just not sure about the width, but I can tell you that you know, you'll have plenty of room. These will sit quite high when you've got them sleeved, but they look like they'll all sort of go right up to the top there. So you've got these event boards that sit over the top. Now there is something that's supposed to go in here. There might be some special agent tokens or something here. You've got these dark agent tokens. You've got these little circular, I'm not sure what they are, tokens. Got these ones here. There's something that's supposed to go in here, but I'm not sure what it was. So, yeah. Anyway, you've got these little event sort of standees as well that all sit in here like this. And yeah, lovely. So, plenty of room there for those cards. Pop that on the top. Okay. Whoopsie daisy. Whoopsie. See, it's all pretty self-explanatory there. Nice. And that'll go on top there. And last of these three trays. This is the map tiles mostly. So you do have a lot of the stuff from the previous game in here. So you've got your, I forget what these are called, but sort of your attribute domination sort of tiles and things like that here. These are the two original dice. I'll probably swap these out for that other two because I like using them a lot. You've got all your tiles, so I've kind of got a range where a lot of the original tiles are over on this side and all the new tiles are over on this side, and you can sort of just access them as you need. You've got your little black, they're very hard to see in there, but your black cubes. I've put all the extra black cubes that we got in one of these new expansions in here as well. It didn't seem to say to differentiate them into one of those other trays, so I've just got them all sitting in there. And these are some random tokens from the original game. So that they're all sitting there. And then, yeah, this is an example. So instead of having these in their own individual little shallow circular wells that don't really need to be there, they're just in this nice little well there that they can sit in. So, yeah, fantastic. So that's the map tile tray. Pop that on top. All right, so now you can see in the bottom layer here, see if I can zoom in, I wonder if this is going to work. Yep, okay, so we've got the board itself, so a big hexagonal board. Okay, oopsie-daisy, there we go. Didn't do that very well. But that's it. There is this sort of, I don't know if you can see that very well, but there's this line here that sort of sits in along, so it keeps that in place. At the bottom here, we do have all of the spaces for the minis, and then you've got your two remaining player trays that sit in there. Now these minis sit in there pretty nicely. There is an extra spot, I guess. Through doing this, I realised I don't have the other. I think it's another just an alternate version of this guy, this Ronak guy, whatever his name is, or the, I forget what his name is actually, but. Is that Ronak? I don't know. But yeah, there's an alternate version of this guy, and that model goes in there. I think that was like a bonus you could have ordered through one of the Kickstarters. You've got all these other ones here. The only thing I would say with these are they don't seem to fit in quite as nicely as they did in the previous tray. For example, this lady's head is pushing up against this... I don't know if you can see that. Let me get these cards out of the way. So this lady's head is pushing up against this piece here. This guy here, as he goes in... He's bending that spear in there, so just not quite perfect. I kind of recommend just like leave him in sitting gently rather than really forcing him down in there, but even like that, it's still bending that spear quite a bit. So yeah, not quite as protective, I would say. They didn't quite get the measurements right with this for these minis. I don't know, maybe if these minis are, if they had to, when they were retooling them for this this wave, if the minis are slightly got different dimensions to the previous ones or whatever it might be from the mold or whatever, but yeah, just a heads up there. But apart from that, everything else is really nice quality, really keeps everything in place. So let's try and box that back up again, so see how easy that is. So we pop that on the top there. I might put one of the card sets in here, and then we can slide these guys in the top, slide them across, take our big card wells there. I should have done this with the lighter one. There we go. Okay, that's nice. Then I said we had these three sitting here, didn't I? Sitting over the top, locking themselves in there. Yep, okay. We've got our Odyssey board, I think it's called. I forget exactly how I had these. Oh, did I have this sitting on the top? Maybe I had this sitting on the top. But this stuff, it doesn't really matter, I don't think, exactly how you slide this stuff in, as long as you get it in there somehow. Let's check this out. Alrighty then. Hopefully that went over a lot of people's heads. I think I sort of said something that could be made fun of there. Alright, so we'll pop that on top there. And pop that there. We've got our three little baggies here. One, two, three. Oh, we can even chuck these in too. Let's chuck them on top. Shouldn't be too much lid lift there. All right, we've got our big lid. Slide that down over the top. And Bob's your uncle, or possibly your granddad. All right, in my case. All right, so let's zoom out again. And that's your gigantic big box, the Archive of the Ancients. I think it's the first time I've actually referenced the proper name of this box in the whole video. But yeah, the Archive of the Ancients, the Vindication, big new box storage solution for Vindication, and I think at least three of its, or now four of its expansions, all in the one place. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that. I hope your copy of this gets to you soon if you're waiting on it. It looks like all the the fulfillment is underway and sort of heading towards you very soon. So yeah, thanks very much, Orange Nebula. Great game, enjoy playing it as always, and now we've got a nice new storage solution for it. So yeah, thank you very much. Thanks guys, Meeple Monkey out. Bye bye.